There's a lot of stuff happening in Nevada right now. Our county's getting hit. Washington County's getting hit. And they're trying to take away literally the sale of live animals so that no one can sell live animals. Southern California, and it's starting with the dogs and the cats, and it's going to start working its way down. And it will happen, so you need to be proactive and protect your way of life, okay? Federal level, there's all kinds of things, and the biggest one that I'm going to talk about here in just a minute is the Endangered Species Act. Anybody heard of ESA? Okay, to a certain level. And my little thing at the bottom is no one's responsibility individually or organizationally to tell you what has happened, what's going to happen, or what can happen. You are your own best activist, and you need to be proactive in that respect, okay? So the first one is the Endangered Species Act. How many of you know what that is exactly? Okay. In the United States, thank you. In the United States, ESA, the Endangered Species Act, was put in place to govern a whole bunch of different things. The situation that we're in right now is it is governing our capability to not only breed parrots, certain species, but also to sell them statewide, so interstate, state to state, without having a permit, okay? And also to transport them, to take them to a vet, to take them on vacation. There's all kinds of things that can go wrong. Currently listed, a blue throat macaw, okay? And if you have never heard of a blue throat macaw and saw it and thought it was a blue and gold macaw, you can tell the difference. This is my friend Buddy Losky, who's a free flyer and back east. He's a blue throat. That's a blue gold, and that's a blue throat. You can see the difference. And they're distinctively much different in size as well, and a different coat, actually. Okay? The lesser silver cockatoo or the silver crested cockatoo just recently got listed. That also includes the subspecies of the citron cockatoo, also got listed. Also on that list is going to be the golden cockatoo. Golden cockatoo's been here for a while. There's also some other Amazons and things that aren't necessarily in your pet trade, but they pop up every now and then, like a Venetian Amazon or a Cuban Amazon. They are ESA listed, and what that means is that you cannot sell or buy outside of the state without an endangered species permit. Okay? Coming up, and this really does, these are excellent animals in the pet trade and also breeder ones. But just because you don't have an ESA permit as a breeder doesn't make you any less of a breeder. It just means that you haven't jumped through the hoops governmentally to be able to get your permit. Species that are ready to be listed. We have the hyacinth macaw. So if we're in California and we don't breed a lot of hyacinth macaws and we normally get them out of Florida to meet our needs, we're not going to be able to do that anymore. So suddenly Florida becomes flooded with hyacinth macaws, but no one else in the nation can partake in, you know, growing like Sarah. If okay? Because some pairs will not fledge an animal. So Clark is the exception to the rule. He was just pulled from his parents 2 weeks ago. He's completely weaned. He's parent fledged. He's relatively tame. Did you notice he's not freaking out? If you may. Birds and one of the biggest problem birds that we have. And my much more of an even temper to them, where you don't hit so much of the hormonal swings that you do with the larger ones. Which is a really nice little Amazon and a sweet type of package. These guys are, you don't see them that often. Here I have them, they're $9.50, but they'll go anywhere from $7.50, $8.50. It just depends on where you're getting them from. And you should be able to double your money at the retail. So, we have one more. So this is a little blue front Amazon. She's very sweet, which to me, in my opinion, is quite rare. Amazons, as most of people know, don't necessarily like to be fed and loved on. Okay, they tend to be more independent, but they'll certainly step up and hang out with you. Another good little cocker. Blue fronts are readily available and easy to get. Some cases, as a hand-fed, unfinished baby, you can see them as low as $150. So, but still a really great, 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 great bird.
I think they're red crown parrots. I live down in San Diego, and every July they come and migrate up to my house in a group of 16 or so.
Yeah.
And they'll kick it around for about a month or so. Then I go up to school in LA, and then I swear they fall. It's the same like group. They follow me up there, and it's even larger. Yeah.
Yeah, they have patterns. Yeah, and there's all kinds of different San Francisco.
Mm-hmm.
There's the blue crowns and the migrants of San Francisco, and they can reactivate. Quakers in Chicago.
Really?
Uh-huh. And it freezes and gets nasty in Chicago. And they have survived for years. But they can do it. And it's a combination of not only people feeding them, but then also learning how to forage to get each the date, the palm dates.
They make a mess of my trees. It's so funny, though.
Yeah. Okay, so then the next one, we're going to move along here. Conure family. Now, of course, the conure family is broad and very large, but you have two major species. You have the pyera and you have the aratinga, okay? Most people, when you're dealing in retail and you're talking to the public, they think conure and they go, oh my goodness, they're loud. Well, they've only come to know the aratinga side. They have not come to know the pyera side. Okay, so the pyeras are going to be your green cheeks and all their mutations. And the green cheeks come in so many different colors now. You have pineapple, the yellow side, and cinnamon. You have a mint. You have a cinnamon dilute. You have sun cheeks. Turquoise, they do yellow side of turquoise. A little turquoise. I mean, it's infinitely large. And they're priced accordingly, so your green cheeks started, you could probably buy them as cheap as $75 or cheaper out of the nest and hand feed them. You can see them as high as, depending upon what end of the country you're on, $250 retail or lower or higher. It just depends on what you can get from the public, okay? So, in here, you have a little Nande.
Aww.
Nandes, you don't necessarily see too often. Nandes are actually, they're wild in Florida, okay? They have survived in Florida quite well. Nandes, unfortunately, because they are so loud, are greatly underappreciated, but in my opinion, one of the smartest little conures. So they're very easy to get trained, and they're sweet little guys. And they have little red hoops on the bottoms of their feet, bottom of their legs. They come in. So, Nanny Conure, not seen too often. And we have Polly Parrot, the little blue crown. Blue crowns you don't see a lot. They came into popularity with Polly the movie. They And then I brought just one little tiger up for you, a maroon belly, which you don't see maroon bellies too often. In my opinion, they tend to be relatively nippy as they get older. But still very a nice little hunter for the right person. The green cheeks will beat them out 10 times over. So, and then of course your sun hires, which are the most popular. They're the ones that give all the irritators the bad name because they're so screechy, but excellent pet nonetheless. And also one of the most colorful. Green cheeks, gendid, suns. Who else am I forgetting? Then you can get into all the Africans, your Senegals, Myers. Excellent, excellent small pets. I have quite a few people that want to come in and buy for small children. That's a tricky one because some have actually already done the cockatiel or the small hunter and they want to step up. I have no problem introducing them to a Senegal or a Myers. I think they offer a lot of personality and a lot of parent in a smaller package, and a small child being supervised. The small child being supervised can be taught how to handle that bird without a problem. And you really do have a great amount of talking ability. The problem with poicephalus there again with a lot of these other birds is that they're getting hard to find. So you're going to start paying more for Senegals, and I would say that on a retail market you're probably going to have to start paying them at like $600. And that's where it starts coming in. Okay, and then the last one. Lorries are coming up in popularity on the pet market, length is going to be about that, but a little bit larger. But head to tail, they're still going to be probably about like that big. They're a good size bird. Very, very smart. I have one pet store who buys nothing but black cats because her customers absolutely love them.
Thank you.